In terms of Serge Gnabry, you know, as we've seen his journey, you know, as a scout yourself and being able to watch many, many games, what's your take on the whole aspect of Serge Gnabry and how he's improved so much? How could someone not really take a risk at him? Because, you know, he had his journey where he went through West Brom, and apparently Tony Pulis said that he's not good enough to play for West Brom. You know, so and now he's one of the best players in the world. So what's your take on, you know, a journey like Serge Gnabry?
Well, it's funny you mention him because he's a player I'd watched in Arsenal's 23s or reserves. Mm. And I actually recommended him.
Okay.
I don't know how many years ago this was, but when he was a young lad, maybe 18, 19, I can't remember exactly. And I thought he was an exciting attacking player. Mm. I can't even remember which club I was working for at the time, but I said if we couldn't buy him, but if we could get him on loan, I thought he would be a good attacking option, young skill, pace. Didn't really find his feet at Arsenal, but maybe he didn't always get the opportunities he should. Went out to West Brom. Obviously, I've worked for Tony Pulis. He works a particular style of football. He wants players to be effective. If you aren't prepared to do all of the things that he needs to do in terms of with the ball, but also without the ball, then you're not going to fit into his team and he's not going to play you. If you don't show the right mentality and the right attitude, and sometimes with a younger player, that's hard to reproduce every week because you haven't built up the mental resilience, because football isn't just about physically what you're doing technically, although they are important. You'll have seen it yourself working in a professional environment, the mentality you require to be at it every day. And young players don't always have that. And you know, Tony generally doesn't play younger players as much. He generally works with more seasoned professionals. And there are some managers who prefer to do that. There are some managers that will take more risks on younger players or prefer to work with younger players because they find them more coachable or more malleable. It's just being in the right club at the right time with the right manager. And sometimes loans don't work out. Certainly when we're working as scouts and looking to get players into clubs, if you're a lower level club, and I've worked at, you know, League One, Championship, League Two, when you take a player, you, generally their first loan isn't always successful. And generally, if you take a player on their second loan, the chance of them being a success at your club during that loan are much higher. However, you can't have a second loan without having had a first loan. So you've always got to get through that. And I just felt maybe the situation at Westbrook just didn't look right for me for him for the first place. If you said, right, Serge Gnabry, the type of player is what I'd seen in reserve team football. Who are you going to put him with? Tony Pulis wouldn't have been one of the managers I would have picked for him. So, you know, he's gone back to Germany and he's done phenomenally well. And, you know, I remember watching, was it last season he played against Arsenal and absolutely tore them to shreds, or the season before?
Yeah.
And you just sort of going, you know, there is an emotional element to the game. And that's what sometimes makes it the most interesting game to work in. And I think that certainly was a night for him where everything, all his stars aligned and he just put in a top performance. So sometimes it's got to be the right club, the right manager and the right environment at the right time. I remember working at a League One club and we had a player from Middlesbrough on loan. Very talented youth international. Very good. It was a central defender, really good footballer, okay defender, but he was still only sort of 19, 20. And we were having a really tough season and he struggled with the defensive side of the game because we were under so much pressure. This is a player now that's been touted for millions of pounds to go to the Premier League, but he struggled in League One because what we were under pressure wasn't one of his strengths. And what he was good at, which was being with the ball, which makes him look a better defender than other players in certain arenas, he wasn't getting a chance to express. So it's, you know, it's just got to be the right time. That's sometimes why it doesn't work.
Now, it's interesting. There's so much factors that play into a player's development, like even advice, like he said, in terms of maybe the advice that Serge Gnabry was getting, you know, his advisors should have said, you know, I don't think it's the right club for you to go with Tony Pulis because he doesn't play your sort of style. So it's like, you know, in one way, I mean, it is a bit, you know, strange for someone to say that he's not good enough. But again, it all comes down to opinions, and that's what football is. So we'll definitely touch a little bit more in terms of, you know, player development later on down the line.